And so I want to really talk about that too, because you're kind of like first in many, many ways. Like mm-hmm. you're mm-hmm. the first artist in Korea who tried using computer making art and without doing really anything other than uploading it. Mm-hmm. They want you to become an artist. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You use a lot of different mediums since mm-hmm. then, not just the computer digital work, but mm-hmm. also paintings and everything. Yep. So just tell me about mediums and, you know, mm-hmm. like why mm-hmm. do you want to
use a lot of
use
mediums?
A lot of medium. Yeah.
As I said, I didn't study art, but I always had these craves of art ever since I started working as an artist. And because in art, I think idea is more important than craftsmanship. That's what I think. Obviously, I can hire people to use some kind of mediums that I can't use. Something like graffiti. I co-work with graffiti artists and make them paint on my paint as a background and so on. Art is a kind of orchestra. I think I am a conductor, and then I ask people to do what I can do because I don't know how to use some kind of medium. But I don't think using what kind of medium is priority of the art. I always thought idea is more important. Let's talk about gold. I wanted to make Korean style work, but I didn't study Korean art at all, so I don't know how to use that kind of mediums. But I really wanted to use gold leaf. So I wanted to know how to use with gold leaf, and then that is very difficult to use it. Also, the gold leaf is very expensive because it's pure gold, and then it's very thin. If you hold it, it breaks. If you look at Korean classic arts from Goryeo dynasty, and they used a lot of gold in their Buddhism work. So I want to use that technique into my work. So I had my assistant and brought down to Buya. Gold master was living there, and then I've learned gold plating from her. Mm. And then my assistant learned that too. So ever since then, we used gold on my work too. So I think who's using what kind of techniques on my work is important, but I'm working as a conductor.
Okay. So you wanted to bring that up, mm-hmm. the masterwork mm-hmm. to the modern world, right?
I didn't study art. That's why I wanted to show more about that I can use a lot of mediums.
Different mediums.
Yeah, I can use it too. I didn't study art, but right. I can use it.
Right, right. Very ironically, let's say you didn't really major it, but because of that, you are hungry to do more than other artists who only studied art.
Yeah, of course.
And you were a professor.
Oh yeah.
In here.
Oh yeah.
In university.
Yes. That was my secondary job because I had to make a living. That was a good experience. I don't go to school anymore because I think getting used to everything is not very exciting for me and to the students too. Uh-huh. So.
Oh, okay. So yeah, you try so many different things also, not just the mediums, but in your daily routine mm-hmm. and, you know, you want to try out a lot of different things.
I like trying things. Yeah.
So talking about bringing up the history back to the modern world, you did the performing art inspired by Yayoi Kusama.
Yep.
So tell me about that. That was kind of sensual, like a lot of people like try to, you know,
attended to
your show, your live
performance. From 2016, my theme of exhibition was masterpiece. And then for that, I wanted to do something special, and then I wanted to use my body. Ever since then, women's rights, the Me Too movement, a lot of female movement rose from then. Yeah. So I wanted to be a part. I was looking at all the masterpieces and I saw Kusama Yayoi. Mm. She became a master now, but when she was younger, when she was in New York, she wasn't really famous, but she wanted to be famous. And then I think that's very brave for Japanese female artists to go to New York and they're doing this kind of performance using her body. Back then, she was wearing this body stocking and then giving out these circles to people. Wow. And that performance was interesting for me. So I wanted to use that outfit and then the circle. I wanted to use that, but in different theme. Mm. So I wanted to try where people look when they look at female's body, and then will they actually admit that they look at some place? Some people are very honest. Oh, I saw your hair. And then, oh, yeah. Okay. But that's not my point. Uh-huh. When you actually recognize that I am there wearing this, uh-huh. then where do you want to look first? Right. I want to try their instincts. Yeah, that was a good try. Yeah. Mm,
yeah, it could be interesting. I want to also talk about, you know, we talked about books. You read a lot of books mm-hmm. and you watch a lot of movies. Mm-hmm. So tell me about it. Like, why did you get interest in them? And
when I made my book in year 2007, and I made this book named Idol, also called Marie Kim's Kaleidoscope. Mm-hmm. And then this kaleidoscope means it's idol's eyeball. Eyeball has a pattern of a kaleidoscopes. Mm. Yeah, so the kaleidoscopes are all in my idols. They, wow, yeah, okay. they are placed. So in my work, yeah. usually they have kaleidoscopes in their eyes, mm. and then people ask a lot about it. What is this? And then I often say this is wormhole because mm. there is a saying, eyes are window to the heart, yeah, heart okay. right? That means this eye can reveal the heart, what I think and what I feel. I think the eyes are only one okay. inner part. Yeah, yeah, visual, uh-huh. but it can be shown in outside. So I think that's kind of a wormhole, connects outside to inside. Oh, okay. So in the wormhole sense, I wanted to know what is wormhole. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So wormhole is, it's a different to black hole, say that what is black hole, and then I wanted to find out how the time works and how the space works. I think that is connected to all philosophies and Buddhism, and then it can be connected to any kind of philosophies. So if you think about the wormhole connects the world to another.
You had to read a lot of books, science related books, in order to explain and understand about
the eyes and why it's important, why it's connected.
Yeah. Ah, I see. So eyeballs are connection towards the universe and us.
Yeah.
Our world.
Yeah, it connects everything.
Ah, it connects everything. Interesting.